Hello everyone, I am Devanshu Kumar and today I will be discussing a problem named Zero Path Operations. This was a question of Hacker Earth, November EZ 2019. Okay, so let's start. In this question we were given that we have n nodes and n minus 1 edges. Each node has a weight wi which is non-negative, means each of the weight is greater than or equal to 0. And we were given that path cost is calculated as, suppose we want to go from node u to v, then the nodes in between, like suppose u to a, then a to b, then b to c, then c to v, then the path cost will be the weight of a, b and c, right? So the path cost will be weight of a plus weight of b plus weight of c. Okay, then a path is said to be beautiful if the path cost from u to v is equal to 0. Okay, so and then in the given question we were asked to find such and we were given that in one operation we can change the weight of one node. One operation we can change weight of one node at once. Okay, and then we were given to find in how many minimum operations we can satisfy this given constraint, that b of u to v for each u to v is equal to 0. Now what I mean by this is path from each of the node to another node of the graph will be that path cost should be equal to 0. Now what I mean by this, that I will be explaining a bit by four nodes. Let's just take 1, 2, 3, 4 nodes. Then the path cost of 1 to 1, 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, and 2 to 1, 2 to 2, 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 3 to 1, 3 to 2, 3 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1, 4 to 2, 4 to 3, 4 to 4. The sum of all this should be equal to 0. Okay, and one more thing, important part was here. When we are going from node U, suppose visited A, B, C and D, the path cost is exclusive of the weight of these two nodes. Means the path cost will only include the weight of these three nodes. Okay. So if you have not tried this question yet, I would suggest to pause the video now and try to solve this question. Okay, now we'll start discussing the solution. So what was the simple logic in this question is, suppose we have two nodes U and V connected directly, then obviously their path cost will be zero because there is no intermediate nodes in between. Now when we have a node A in, suppose node A in between U and V, the path cost will be the weight, will be nothing but the weight of A. So to satisfy the given constraint, the weight of A should be equal to 0. So simply if you have a look at the given tree, then any node which has a degree greater than 1, okay, here if you see the degree is 1, here if you see the degree is 1, here degree is 1, here degree is 2, a degree is 1. So any node having a degree greater than 1 should have a weight 0. Now let me give you one more example with that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, let's just say here 6, then here 7. If I calculate the degree here, it is 1, 3, 3, 1. 1, 2 and 1. So if you see here, the nodes which are having degree 1 are not in path of any other nodes, so I don't need to change their weights. But if you see the nodes which are having degree greater than 1, suppose node 2, it is in between node 1 and 3, okay, and 1 and 5. So obviously the weight of this 2 should be equal to 0. Okay, similarly this 3, the whichever node has a degree greater than 1 is in path of one or the other node. Okay, so let's just say here 6 I have, it is in between the path of 3 to 7, right? So obviously the weight of this should be also set to 0 if it is not 0. Okay, so this was the simple logic. Count the number of nodes which have degree greater than 1 and check if they have zero weight. Otherwise, increment one operation plus plus, because then I obviously need to change their weight. Okay, so I will just walk you through the code now. Okay, so this was the simple code. Just included the libraries fast.io, right? These two lines of a fast.io, you can ignore them as well, right? And then I'm just declaring the variables, test number of test cases t, number of nodes n, and x and y are the temporary variables I will be using later. So firstly, I'm taking the test cases. How many test cases are there? That input, declared array count. This count will be nothing but the degree. What will be my degree of nodes? Okay, and then answer. Answer will be my final answer. Then while test cases, for each of the test cases, then okay. Firstly, I'm setting the degree of each node to be zero. Zero initialization. Okay. And then I'm setting my answer to zero. And then I'm taking n input. How many nodes are there? Basically, and then I'm just incrementing the count. So basically, if I have a connection from x to y, so then the degree of x should be incremented by plus 1 and degree of y should be incremented by plus 1. So simple, right? I'm just incrementing the count, the degree basically. And then I'm checking for each node, for each of the node, I'm checking the weight. This x is nothing but the weight. I'm taking the input weight. What is the weight of the given node? Okay, the wi I mentioned, that will be in the form of array for 0 to n, right? So that w weight I'm taking here, and I'm not storing that weight. I'm just checking if that weight is not equal to 0. Okay, and I have the count greater than 1, means I have a degree greater than 1. So basically I can write here, if weight is not equal to 0 and degree is greater than 1. So basically then I just increment the answer or operations, and finally I just output the number of operations required. That will be my minimum number of changes required to be done, so that the full given constraint are satisfied. Okay, so I hope I explained it well. If you have any doubts, please do mention them in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please do like the video if you found the video helpful. Do press the like button and subscribe. Yeah, happy coding. Thank you.